This video gives a grand overview of Chapter 1, which is about algorithms. What is an algorithm? An algorithm is a sequence of instructions for a human or a computer. An algorithm is used to perform a computation and typically computes a function. In this chapter, we learn some basic principles of algorithms. Many interesting algorithms are using recursion. A recursive algorithm is an algorithm that calls itself as a subroutine, like in this example where the function f calls itself in the last line. Backtracking is closely related to recursion. When using backtracking, we constructively build a valid solution to a computational problem using recursion. In this lecture, program code is displayed in the programming language Python. Python is arguably the most easily readable programming language. If you have never encountered the Python language, you should study our Python cheat sheet, which fits on a single sheet of paper. Our next video is about dynamic programming, which combines backtracking with a greedy algorithm. Thanks to this combination, dynamic programming can potentially speed up a computation drastically. Dynamic programming is also often used when we not only want to find a solution to a problem, but when we want to count how many solutions exist. We study both versions of dynamic programming: top-down dynamic programming, also known as memoization, and bottom-up dynamic programming, also known as tabulation. To appreciate the value of dynamic programming, we need to understand how much time an algorithm takes to solve a problem. This computation time is called the time complexity, and it is usually measured using asymptotic analysis, with the O notation. These three videos complete the first part of Chapter 1. We now know some powerful algorithmic techniques that are all related to each other. Many computational problems can be solved with these techniques. However, there are problems for which other approaches are better suited. In the second part of this chapter, we learn such a technique, known as linear programming. A linear program can express and solve any optimization problem with only linear constraints and a linear objective function. Linear programs can be extended in many ways. They are the entry point to a rich mathematical field known as convex optimization. In the next video, we study integer linear programs. These are linear programs for which we insist that the solution variables need to have integer values. One idea is to naively solve the corresponding linear program. If the solution consists of non-integer values, we may round them to an integer. This technique is known as linear relaxation. A prominent linear programming application is the flow problem. We first discuss how to express a flow problem as a linear program. Then we learn that sometimes we can guarantee integer solutions. And finally, to come full circle, we learn how to solve flow problems with just a simple greedy algorithm which uses backtracking as a subroutine. Algorithms are the basis for computations. As a result, this chapter naturally connects with all other chapters. For example, we are going to learn that reinforcement learning is closely related to dynamic programming. Thanks for watching this video.